Hi friends, good morning all of you and welcome back to our online class science 7th standard. Students, today we are going to continue again that same chapter, continuing our the heat chapter, that is the 4th chapter. Yes, so in previous video already we have learned about that the clinical thermometers. Okay students, and which one we are using generally in for the measuring the body temperature. And especially the doctors are using this clinical thermometer. Yes, okay. So almost all you have, whenever you suffer that fever or your body temperature increasing, that time whenever you go to doctor, near to doctor, at that time the doctors first will keep that thermometer under that your arm or your armpit. Okay. So why they will keep that? Now because they will find out what is the body temperature. Okay. So they will find out the temperature of your body. So but while we are doing to temperature in the laboratory or in what is the temperature of water, now we are boiling. So what is the temperature of that water, or what is the temperature of that milk, or what is the temperature of that any other liquid? So at that time we cannot use this thermometer, clinical thermometer we cannot use. Okay, because the range is less. So whenever we need more temperature, 100 degree temperature, 100 degree above temperature shall there. So at that time 100 degree Celsius more than 110 or less than also 0 degree. So at that time we need another one special type. We are using one different special type of thermometer, that is called as a laboratory thermometer. Specially that thermometer we are using in lab, in whenever we are doing that chemical reactions, at that time we are specially we are using this laboratory thermometer. So let us discuss today what is the laboratory thermometer and what are the applications and what are this. Okay, see students, laboratory thermometer, so to measure the temperature of the other things other than human body, we use laboratory thermometer. Students, I explained to you, other than the human body, what is the temperature of human body? For that we are using the doctor's thermometer or clinical thermometer. But other than the human body, other things, what the temperature of other things, that means the temperature of the liquid, the temperature of the milk or any chemicals, whatever that we are using, for that we are using the laboratory thermometer. And since the ranges of the laboratory thermometer is how much means, remember that -10 degree to 110 degree Celsius. Okay, so let us discuss about that laboratory thermometer. I have drawn here students, observe here, same as it like our clinical thermometer, but its ranges is different. And it has what is that? Liquid also is there here. It is, this is also bulb. This is capillary tube where that liquid will be pass. And this is a glass thermometer. Okay, this is scale. Are you clear? So this is the construction you should draw in your classwork also. This thermometer. Okay. So now, what is the precautions? What are the precautions of the laboratory thermometer? Students, how like you have taken the precautions of clinical thermometer, same as it we have to take care and you have to take the precautions of a laboratory thermometer. So see one second, what are the difference, little difference there, for that we have to see. Should always follow the same precaution as that of the clinical thermometer. How like you have washed before using that, you have to wash and you have to keep in your mouth, same like, and you have to carefully you have to see that eye leveling. And same other thing, not change, but you have to take care about that. Okay, same as the clinical thermometer. And second one is only little difference here. Students here observe, hold the laboratory thermometer in straight upright position without tilting. So observe students, clinical thermometer, how like you suppose this is one clinical thermometer, this is the bulb, mercury bulb here is there. We are keeping like this. We can keep it under the tongue. Okay, so whenever we are keeping, we can change it, no problem. But while you are using laboratory thermometer, we should not do like that. Okay, what you have to do? You have to keep upright, that means straight position you have to keep. Suppose you observe here, I have drawn that here in picture. This is one top and here some hot water is there. We have to measure the what is the temperature of a hot water. So the laboratory thermometer you have to put like this. Are you clear? The water top is there. So under, do you understand or not? You have to, suppose I have brought that here, suppose here observe that students, see this is of glass of some water. So what is the temperature of that water? So if this is a laboratory thermometer, that you have to keep like this. Don't keep like this or keep like this, no need. So you have to keep straight, straight keeping after bottle open. And another thing also, friends, this bulb, that means this last part, should not touch to that bottom, that don't touch to that surface of that. Okay, so just, but it should be covered to that your bulb. The water should cover or the which things you are going to measure, that should be touched to this and surrounded it, but it should not be touched that tip of that thermometer should not touch to the bottom. Okay, it should not come to here last. It should be deep into the water, but it should not be touched to the bottom of that surface. Okay, so and it should be like this. And you don't, after that, suppose it, you kept like this. Now you kept like this, you have it is there. Then after what happened? The temperature you will read. How like will see that? How like will measure the temperature? How will find out the temperature? Where it is? Now you don't have to take out. How like you are seeing that in clinical thermometer? Suppose you are kept there 1 minute for that in term. Then after you are taking out. Yes? And you are seeing like this. But in laboratory thermometry it is little different. What is that? You cannot take out. What you have to do? You have to go there and you have to observe like this. Without disturbing this, you have to keep like this and you check like this only. Whenever, because you will take out like this, then the temperature will change. Okay, students? So in laboratory thermometer, hold it like this and check. Don't take out, don't disturb. But clinical thermometer we can take out and we have to parallel up to our eye and you can see. Okay, students, this is the difference of the laboratory thermometer and a clinical thermometer. Are clear? So next, here I already have written, bulb should be surrounded from the all the sides of the substances of which the temperature is to be measured. Which substance we are milk you are taking, that milk should be touched to every surroundings of that bulb. Okay, and it should not be touched to the bottom. Ball should not touch the surface. This ball, here I have kept the place here. Here water is there already. So this ball up to here will be. Up water level up to here it will stay. But here it should be some distance. That means don't touch. Okay, students. This is the laboratory thermometer. Did you understand, students? Much reminding you, its ranges is minus 10 degree to 110 degree. That means more temperature whenever you are measuring, that time you are using laboratory thermometer. And clinical thermometer only for the body temperature. Our, what is the body temperature? For that we are using the clinical thermometer. But laboratory thermometer we are using the temperature of the other substances. May it liquid, may it other chemical substance or whatever may. Okay, students? So thank you all of you. And we will study about that next thermometer, like maximum minimum thermometer, also one special type of thermometer, and also digital thermometer and other things in the next video. Okay, students, thank you very much.